We are back at one of my favorite places for our year-end wrap-up video, and that of course is Central City Brewing down at the bottom of Scott Road in Surrey. One of my favorite breweries, as always, you know that we've been here before. I love this place, and we are trying. It's called the No Friends on a Powdery Day Vanilla Stout. They gave me a taster of this at the bar, and it is absolutely incredible. It comes in their taster pack, so they've got one of those really cool beer advent calendars that you can buy. They are incredible. They're on sale right now. Come check them out if you can, and look how dark and beautiful that is. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Ooh, that is good. Well, I am excited to be with you because it is the end of the year where we do our predictions. We look at what we think is gonna happen in 2019. We look back on 2018 and the predictions that we made at the end of 2017 to see if indeed what we thought was gonna happen did happen. Before we get to our predictions, let's do a little bit of a year in review. 2018 was a crazy, crazy year in real estate. And basically the reason for that is because we had that mortgage stress test, that dreaded mortgage stress test that we've heard lots about. I wanted to let you guys know and give you a little bit of an example of how substantial that has been on our market and really what that mortgage stress test has meant for a buyer. To illustrate how the mortgage affordability in the current rising rate and stress test environment has had an effect, check this out. So in June of 2016 is when the first stress test was actually announced. Now, this was for people that had less than 20% down, really to make sure that they had more skin in the game, making them qualify at rates about 2% higher than what the posted rate was. Now, this had a pretty big difference on entry-level buyers, first-time buyers into the marketplace. Also, the rates have gone up substantially since that time. So we were in an environment where the interest rates were at about 2.39 on a five-year fixed mortgage. And today, we're sitting in right around about a 3.5% rate. So in June 2016, at a five-year fixed rate of 2.39, there's a few assumptions here, but a couple that was making $100,000 of income and at 20% down, wanting to buy a $1 million house, at that point qualified for $800,000. Come June, 1 year later in 2017, we saw a slight rate increase up to 2.69, and that mortgage amount qualified for it now went to $775,000. Bringing down your affordable price of purchasing to 968. December of that year comes by and the rates had increased significantly from 2.69 to 3.34. You once qualified at 800, you're now down to 700,000, removing almost $100,000 worth of purchasing power from you as a consumer. Now, January 2018 is when the remainder of the stress test came into play. What that meant is people that had more than 20% down now also had to qualify at these new rates about 2% higher than what was posted. The mortgage rate being the same at 3.34 as of January 2018, now look at the effect this has had in terms of your purchasing power. Originally at 800,000 of June of 2016 is now down to 575 for a mortgage amount qualified for. This means that the total purchase price of June 2016 of about $1 million has now moved to $718,000. That's almost $300,000 of change. Today, well, interest rates again have since moved and we're up at about the 3.5 to 3.8 mark right now for a five-year fixed. The mortgage amount qualified for is now $525,000, down from $800,000, and the total purchase price after the 20% down is at $656,250. Now, again, there's some assumptions made in that math, so it's not gonna be exactly the same for everybody, but that is the effect this mortgage stress test has had on the marketplace. That's why we've seen these higher end properties move in value down from their peak of where they were about a year and a half to 2 years ago. Pretty incredible stuff, and now you know how big that effect has been. So the big question comes is, are we in a bubble? Are we in a real estate bubble? And that has been asked again and again, and I hate that term, but let's talk about that. And that is actually gonna come up with our predictions. Now, before we get into our predictions for 2019, we're gonna look back at 2018, and we're gonna see how accurate I was. If you remember, in the 2017 market, at the end of 2016, we made some predictions, and we were 3 for 3. three, folks. Three for three on getting those right. So let's see how we did for 2018. Here's prediction number one. My first prediction of that year was that interest rates would probably climb up to around 3.5%. We are in a rising interest rate environment. I do see the interest rates going up a little bit more, maybe anywhere between 0.25 to 0.5%. Nailed it. We're right at about 3.5% right now. If you look at comparable rates that mortgage brokers are hosting, you'll see anywhere between 3.5 to 3.89. Pretty damn good. The next prediction for the 2018 market would be sales and growth for detached homes would likely be down, as we are already starting to see a little bit of flattening out on there. Let's see how I did with that one.
As for pricing, I think detached homes will do a slow gain. Much more healthy though. That's actually kind of a good thing.
That's two for two. Sales are down for detached homes. They've been down for quite some time, and we saw the average price growth. We said it would be flat. We've seen the average price growth of a detached home go up 0.6%. That's pretty darn flat.
Two for two.
What about the third prediction?
Condos and townhomes, I don't think condos are quite done yet. I think they're gonna continue their run for another few months, and then they'll probably see them flatten off. Whereas townhomes, I think they're actually gonna flatten off, they are flattening off right now.
Not bad, right? 2018 saw a very strong start for condominiums and townhomes, and then done. It just kind of slowed off, petered off and whatnot. And we've actually seen a little bit of a reseed in those values that were accumulated over the start of 2018. Now, of course, those predictions were very well educated. We saw a lot of real estate, very fortunate to do that, and are very in tune with what's going on in the marketplace. So here is what my predictions are for the 2019 market. Here we go. Prediction number one, rate increases. I predict that in 2019, we are probably gonna see about 1 to 2 more rate increases on our 5-year fixed, bringing us up to around about 3.75 to a 4% interest rate. This is, of course, gonna have an effect on the market, as you saw with what the stress test has done and those increasing rates over the last few years. So stay tuned for that. If you are thinking about getting into a fixed mortgage, always reach out to me. I'm happy to share some advice. Prediction number two is growth. So I do foresee us having a modest growth in the detached market. I kind of been thinking we're gonna end the year of 2019 with about a 1% growth rate in terms of value of what a detached home has done in the Fraser Valley. So we'll have to stay tuned and see what happened. And the third prediction is stratas. I believe townhomes will stay relatively flat for 2019 with very little growth in value. Might stay in and around 1%, give or take, maybe even minus 1%, but we'll stay relatively flat. And I do foresee a little bit of a reseed in condos. That's my guess, and we'll see what happens. But I do have a feeling from where we are today, condos will be worth a touch less tomorrow or at the end of 2019 than they are today. So at this point, let's talk about what your product has done year over year, okay? Let's talk about the last 3 months, and let's talk about what it's done year over year. So you have a very good idea of what your investment is doing right now. We're gonna start with condominiums. In the last 3 months in the Fraser Valley, we have seen a decrease in the value of condominiums for the benchmark price down about 4.68%. Now, year over year though, was buying a condominium last year a good investment? Well, if you bought a condominium last November, because we're using November statistics, of course, it's December, we only have last month to look at, you are up about 12% in your investment. So hey, that's pretty good. That's a heck of a lot better than the stock market's doing right now. That's what condominiums have done in the last year. So I'm not 100% what I was reading when I originally did the townhomes for you guys, but I got it wrong. So here's a little bit of an edit that you never really get to see. In the last 3 months with townhomes, in the Fraser Valley, we saw a decrease of about 2.82%. And what happened in the last year? Well, if you bought a townhome about a year ago, you're still in pretty good shape because you saw an increase of almost 6%. Or better yet, closer to 5. It was about a 5.37% increase year over year on townhomes, so not bad.
And finally, detached homes. Detached homes, as mentioned before, saw an ever slow, slight gain in the average price year over year. When we're talking about benchmark prices though, in the last 3 months, the average detached home in the Fraser Valley is down 3.23%. Now, what about the last year? And again, for benchmark prices, flat, completely flat. There's been no increase, no decrease in the value of a detached home year over year. Pretty incredible, right?
Guys, that's it for this episode of Drinks with Darin. It's December, it's close to the holidays. I wanna thank you all from the bottom of my heart for all the support.
all the introductions, all the good vibes that you guys send me over the years. I know you love watching these videos. I get such great feedback from these. I love coming out to these places and being able to do these with you guys. And it's one way for me to get in front of you and say hello without actually being able to come say hi in person. So thank you so much for working. I appreciate everything you do for me, for my family, my business, and I wish you nothing but success in 2019. Health, happiness, and success. Looking very forward to seeing you all in 2019. Have a great holiday with your families, and we'll see you soon. Take care.